Now introducing Sir Nanogician. Yes, thank you everyone. Okay, so for my first and only trick, I'm going to make Einstein disappear.
Wow.
On the count of three. Abracadabra.
Ooh.
That was part of the show. So let's keep going. Gonna make Einstein disappear now. On three. One. Abracadabra.
Ooh.
It's okay. One more time, I'll bring it all back. Ready, ready. One, two, three. Oops.
Hey, Squints. How exactly does invisibility work? If Harry Potter can become invisible with just a cloak, surely us mere muggles can do it too, right? Well, it turns out the idea of invisibility isn't all that crazy. In fact, scientists have already been able to make several different types of invisibility things, although no invisibility cloaks just yet. We've talked about how we see things, photons of light bounce off objects and into our eyes. Then our brain interprets the photons that we see, which lets us see what is right in front of us. When we talk about invisibility, we're basically just saying that we can see through something, or that we can see what is behind it. For example, I've got this Harry Potter doll. It's definitely a man doll because it's made out of wood, which is always manly, right? So it's okay.
Yeah.
So you can see it because photons bounce off of it and into your eyes. But if I put my hand in front of Harry Potter, you can't see him anymore because photons that bounce off the doll get stuck in my hand and you never see them. Instead, you just see the photons bouncing off my lovely hand. However, if you could make my hand invisible, you'd be able to see that light bouncing off him, and thus see Harry Potter again. And this can be done by bending those photons around my hand and into your eyes. Normally, light travels in straight lines, which makes it hard to curve around objects. But scientists can use magnets or different metamaterials that are able to bend those photons around the object, which makes it look invisible. One way to mimic an invisibility device is to take two phones, video call each other, and then place one facing behind you and the other facing in front of you. The photons of light hit the phone's camera on your back, gets moved to the phone on your front, and then displays what is behind you. So in order for that cloak of Harry Potter's to work, it must be made out of some material that can take those photons of light coming from behind him, bend it around him, and then towards the unknowing potions professor. Or you can keep thinking it's magic. Either way, keep reading, keep asking questions, and keep on squinting. Got a question that you want answered here on Squint Science? Put in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more invisible science. You were the chosen one.